Hey guys, CyberSprite here. In this video, we will be discussing about Kali Linux and about its installation. So let's get started after a short intro. So talking about Kali Linux, it is a Debian-based operating system. It is mainly used as a penetration testing platform, which is generally regarded as a standard package of tools used for penetration testing. So before going further, let's discuss about more things. So what is an operating system? Technically, it is an interface between user and hardware. Till now, you are using a software in which you can further install games or whatever. Linux is one of those. And here are the few known operating systems which you may use till now. Linux is an open source free operating system, so you can configure and customize it by your own way. Linux has more than 500 distributions around the web. You can find all of them on Google, or I will just provide a link for the list in the description box. Here are few distributions which are mainly used for this, like Black Arch, Ubuntu Linux, and Linux Mint, Parrot OS, or Kali Linux. All are same with few differences, like Ubuntu runs mainly on GNOME, whereas Kali Linux supports GNOME, KDE, XFCE, or Mint. Further, there is one more thing. Kali Linux comes with more than 600 pre-installed tools used for penetration testing and ethical hacking. That is why we won't use Windows. It has mainly every tool used for network scanning or penetration testing, like Nmap, Wireshark, Metasploit, and AirCrackNG or Wi-Fi for wireless hacking. So let's talk about how to install Kali Linux in your system. You can install Linux in your PC by three ways. First, you can boot it in your PC with a USB drive. Second, you can use a virtual machine and install Linux with its ISO file. Or third, you can simply run a pre-built image of virtual machines. We won't talk about the first one, but the third one is the easiest one. So for this, we have to install VirtualBox. You can simply download VirtualBox from its official website, virtualbox.org, and from its download section, just download it for Windows or Mac OS. But for 32-bit systems, you can download VirtualBox from here. These are the previous version of VirtualBox which supports 32-bit, but I would suggest VMware for 32-bit system. After installing VirtualBox, you have to download Kali Linux pre-built image. You can download it from its official website kali.org/downloads or in the download section. You don't have to download the ISO file, just scroll down and click on this. Default username and the password is Kali and Kali, so download any of them, but make sure it is for VirtualBox, not from VMware. I have already downloaded the file, so after downloading, simply open the file. It will pop up and ask you for import. Make sure this box is checked. This will take time. Just open the virtual machine by double clicking it or by this start button, and now you can run your Linux easily. So now it is asking for credentials, and we would just type Kali for both username and password. Actually, I have just changed the password from Kali, so I am typing my own password, but you have to put Kali as password here. After logging in, you can run any of these apps you want. We will see these further, but there is a problem here. You have logged in with user Kali, and which is not an administrative user. Like if I would show you opening the root folder and it will deny the permission. So we have to change the password for the root account as we don't know that. Just reset your machine. And then choose the second option and again the second option, but this time press E, not enter. So we will get into the edit mode and then change this RO under the Linux with RW. RO is for read only, whereas RW is for read and write. After that, just add this init equals to /bin/bash and press F10 or Ctrl plus X for reboot, and it will boot into the edit mode. So you can simply change the password from here. So after it completes, you can simply type the command password and but it's not word, passwd, and just give a new password. It is invisible, so won't show up here. Your root password has been changed. So you can simply log in with the root as username and your password. So this is for all now. Hope you like the video. Thank you.